Happy Wednesday. I had a bunch of people I was chit-chatting with on YouTube, and all of a sudden I'm like, oh, it's time to go. I better push the button, right, to make it go. So just a second, I have to see if I can get my tablet going over here. Hi, everybody. Let's see if, oh, it's working. Okay, so now it's working. Yeah, the YouTube allows me to chat with you in advance. Before the actual live starts, but Facebook will not allow me to do that. So it's kind of neat. YouTube's kind of cool because it gives me some other things that we can do. And it's fun to talk to everybody a little bit ahead of time. So that's awesome. So remember, for those of you who are coming in on Facebook, if you want to be entered in the drawing, and give me a second, I'm going to get the drawing stuff going here too. Okay, just a minute. I just need to get the little thing going here. All right. Okay. So those of you who are just coming in from Facebook, a bunch of you are saying things like, hello, everyone from Waterloo. Hi, Jan, I'm here. I'm not seeing your names. So remember, there's a little button you can press in the description right above this video on Facebook. Go click on that and tell YouTube it's okay, or tell StreamYard it's okay for me to see your name, because otherwise you can't get into the drawing either. So it's important that I see your names. If you don't mind me seeing your names, if you don't want to, that's fine. But the little giveaway, you have to have your name showing for Facebook to pick you, because otherwise they won't pick you. So that's the little thing about Facebook. So there's a few of you. Let's see. I was trying to see who I can tell. Diane Castle's one. So I've got a few people that I can see you on Facebook, but I can't see you on StreamYard. So remember, if you want me to see your names and get entered into the drawings, you need to click that little button. It's in the description. There's like a description below the video. You may have to come out of the video and look at the little post, even though it's live, and then go back into it again. Hi, everybody. Cool. We got people coming in. I'm kind of waiting until everybody has a chance to get in here. So that's awesome. Everybody's finding it okay. That's really neat when people can come in and chat with me for a little bit on YouTube. So I'll remember that I'll start it a little earlier so that I can chat with some of you on YouTube, because it will allow me to chat with you. But it doesn't allow me to chat. Whoever said, hope you can still see my name. No, I can't. Colleen Robinson. No, I cannot. So can you go click that button again? If you've cleared your browser history or something like that, or had maybe sometimes a computer upgrade, then it will take that little, it's like a cookie, I imagine. So you like it better on YouTube. I'm glad that I can do both now, because I know I had a lot of people asking me if they could watch me on YouTube, because a lot of people watch on the TV, you know, then you don't have to watch on the computer. So hi, Jan, can you see me? Whoever said that just a couple minutes ago, no, I cannot. Hi, Jan, can you see me? Margaret, no, I can't. Margaret, default. Yes, Robin, I can. Robin Zinkula, yes, I can. Up, Diane, I think you got it. Diane was one of them. Yeah, I like YouTube. Sometimes YouTube works better than Facebook when it comes to... sometimes it's just something with, you may have had an update on your computer. It might've caused your browser history to clear. So don't be concerned, but you may have to do it every now and then. So, but it's nice. Then you get, yes, Pat, I can. Yes, Pat, I can see you. Yep. Yours is fine. And Jackie, I can see you. Yep. That's awesome. Okay. So, this week we're going to put together the pillow. And we're going to just kind of do the whole thing. I just decided, let's just do it, because I know some of you struggle with binding, and I thought I'll just show you the binding, and we'll do the little decorations and everything. And so we'll just have fun putting our little pillows together. So it's not hard, but it's fun. I wanted to let you know that next week we will not have class. So I'm going to teach two lives a month. So starting in February, now it'll be the first and the third Wednesday. So you might want to put that like in your phone or something. It's going to be the first Wednesday and the third Wednesday. And then for those of you who are local, I will be teaching in the store on the second Wednesday of the month in Iowa City and the second Thursday in Davenport. Okay, so we'll have an in-store class the second week. So the first and third week will be here on Sew Along with Jan, okay? Where is my shop? I work in the Iowa City, Iowa Shield Sewing Center. And then I also go down to Davenport. I'm gonna start going back down to Davenport to teach classes once a month, so. But the first and the third Wednesday, so you might want to put that in your phone or something to remind you that we'll have every other week, and I'll try to remind you too. And then let's see, I wanted to remind you about that. So next week we won't have class, but I have a little video for you. Just a second here. I have a video for you next week that I will put up. I did a scan and cut class, and I think I showed this to you last week, that I made a shaker card. So this is my shaker card that I made, a Valentine shaker card on the scan and cut. So there'll be a little scan and cut class for you to see next week that I pre-recorded already. And I even show you how to make custom envelopes, the custom sized envelopes, because some of these envelopes are, this is kind of an unusual size card. It's 6x6. So it's hard to find envelopes. So I'm going to show you how to make an envelope. Okay. So that's going to be the pre-recorded class for next week. And then the first week in February, we're going to do another little Valentine class. We're going to do this little pillow. It's called, A Little Birdie Told Me is what it's called. And this is a free design on kimberbell.com. So if you go to kimberbell.com, look up their free downloads. This is in there for free, this little design. And we'll make this little pillow up. Okay, so this will be the first week in February. All right, and then I just put up the third week in February. The third week in February is going to be, we're going to do some couching. Let me turn the banner off here. It's distracting me. Okay. We're in the Luminaire, in the Luminaires, Solaris, Meridian, Altair, and then the new Stellaires now too, that have been upgraded to the new two, you can couch in the machine. So we're going to do some couching. I haven't done much couching. I just love it. Isn't it pretty? So I'm going to show you how to do the couching. These are all built into the machine. And I'm going to do a couple more samples up before that. And then I don't know if you can see it very well, but I also did the quilting behind the pillow, behind the little butterfly. And I'm going to show you how to do that, because you can't combine designs with the couching designs because it's a different foot for the embroidery. So I'm just going to show you how I did this little quilting design behind the little butterfly. And yes, it would work. It does not work on the Destiny. I'm sorry. Whoever asked about that, I can't see your name either about the Destiny. It's all the newer machines, but the new Stellaire twos and like the Altair twos and all that. And then if you have the upgrade to the first ones, it will work. This is in there. And there's some really cool letters. So I thought I'd sew out some of the lettering for you so you could see that too. So that's coming up the third week in February. Okay. Yeah, I just thought this was so pretty. Now, what size is the pillow? It is 12 by 12, Cindy. It's 12 by 12, and then the inside piece is like 8 by 8. Oh, you were watching videos because you were snowed in. So anyway, this is going to be fun. I have done a little bit of couching, but I thought, you know what, let's just play with something different. I just thought that was really cool. And it's been in the Luminaire and the like Solaris for quite a while. I just haven't played with it that much. And I think it's really neat. So, and it's really easy. I mean, it looks like it's so hard, but it's very easy. So we're going to do that too. So, okay. So that'll be the February classes. And then next week's class is going to be pre-recorded with the card. Okay. So that's already done. And I will put that up next week for you. All right. So what's, and let's see, I think I got the size of the pillow and the lettering is really pretty, isn't it, Lynn? I really do like it. Working on February. Awesome. And I'm going to do the March mini quilt probably this weekend. I'm hoping to record it this weekend. So for those of you who are working on those, I will try to get that done and post it around the 1st of February. So I was hoping I might have time to do it this weekend. So, okay. So let's go ahead and turn the camera down here and we're going to do a little sewing tonight. We're going to put our pillow together. It's very easy to put together. I'm going to show you how I do the binding. Good evening. Hello from Saskatchewan. That's awesome. Hello. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and turn this over and then we'll get ready to do the next section, which will be putting our pillows together. Oh, and by the way, I forgot to tell you what the gift is. So remember, make comments for those of you who are on Facebook, who are not, that I can't see your name, you won't get entered in to win. So go in and click that little button. Okay. It's in the video description. So you might have to go out of the video and then come back into it. But there's a little place you can poke there that'll say, I can see your name. Okay. So do that if you haven't done that. I'm going to tell you what the gift is tonight. The gift will be whoever. Oh yeah. Lynn won the rug. Did you get your rug, Lynn? Tim was going to take it to the store. So I hope you got your rug. So this week, the winner will get the pillow I'm making tonight, the pillow cover. I'm not going to send the pillow form, just the cover for the pillow. So whoever wins tonight will get the pillow that I'm making tonight. So again, this is what we're making, putting it together. So whoever wins tonight will get the pillow cover, just the cover, because it's easier for me to mail if you don't mind. So, okay. All right. So let's get started putting this together. Okay. Let me get the cameras turned over here. I'm getting faster at this. All right. Okay, so you should be able to see. You should be able to see my sewing machine now, hopefully. All right, so what we're going to do, we're just going to do some sewing. I wondered if maybe you would like to win one of the covers. So I had to make several of them and I thought, well, I'll just give away one of the covers tonight. So, okay. So I'm going to try to catch all of the comments. So if you can't, if I didn't answer your comment, if you would put like question in like capital letters before you ask, because it might help me see it a little bit better. Sometimes they scroll through kind of quickly, okay? So if you have a question and I didn't answer it, if you write the word question out in like capital letters and then ask your question, sometimes I can see it better. Okay. All right, so to put this together, we need our panels, and I got all my panels done, even after having the broken needle and all the problems. I got everything done. I did have a problem when I did my last panel. By the way, I don't know if any of you have ever done this, but you know these embroidery feet. Oh, by the way, the Luminaire is a really, really strong machine, and it caught on my stabilizer that was like over here on the side. And, you know, it ate it into my foot and then just bent the foot right off my machine. So I have a new foot. This is my new foot. I just brought it home today. So, you know, things like that happened to me also. So I had to have a new foot today. Okay. So I got my three panels here And I've got, whoops, here's a center one. This is the last one. Let's get them in order here. There we go. Okay. And then I've got my backing pieces. Now the backing pieces are, let's see, they're 12 by 14 inches. And you're going to hem one 12 inch side on each piece. So I already have those hemmed. I just, you know, I just turned it under a half an inch and turned it under a half an inch. Okay. So I already did that in advance because you didn't need to watch me hem that. You can understand that. So on one 12 inch side of each piece. Okay. All right. So I'm going to lay those down here. And let's see, we need binding. Where'd my binding go? Oh, here it is. And you need two pieces of binding. I use 2 1/4 inch pieces by 2 1/4 inch by width of fabric. And you need two of those. Okay. So it's about roughly 80 inches of binding. You could probably get by with about 72 inches, but, and I've got a little bit less. Bernadette, I did not walk away from my machine. I was sitting right here and I turned my head for 1 second and it got caught on my stabilizer. I was sitting right in front of the machine, didn't have anything in front of me. It just, you know, it just happens sometime. And that's the second time I've done this. I didn't have to replace my foot the first time because I had an extra from my other machine so I could use it. And now I've got, I've still got a spare. The other one that bent wasn't bent as badly as this one, the new one. And so I kept it as a spare just to have something to use in case I need to. So it happens. Okay. So I've got my binding and I've already done it. You know, I sewed it together, you know, with your diagonal. Okay. Your diagonal line here. And I folded it in half. So this is 2 1/4 inch binding. If you like 2.5 inch better, go ahead. You know, and use 2.5, but I usually use 2 1/4. So that's my binding. Okay. And then we're, of course, we're going to put on our little buttons here. So I've got my buttons and I'll remind everybody I had a lot of questions. Where do you get them? Let's see who's having trouble knowing where to click. Janet, it's in the video. It's in the description of the video. You may have to back out of the video for a minute and then go back in and then it'll be in the description and then come back into the video to do it. These are very strong machines. So, okay. So here's my little buttons. And I want to remind you again what they were. Most of them were these dress it up buttons. Okay. I got them at Joann's. I got them at Walmart. And I got a couple of the buttons at Hobby Lobby, but they were the little cardinals and they were in the paper studio. So in other words, they were back with the paper crafting stuff, like where they have all the embellishments. So these were back in there and these were the cardinals. Okay. And then I got, the dress it up ones, some of them at Walmart, some of them at Joann's, and it was one called Who. One called Outfoxed, because I had a couple little foxes. One called Forest Babies, and one called Backyard Babies. Okay, so that's some of the buttons I got. And you might be able to find more animal buttons besides those. These were just some that I picked out. And I've got the ones picked out that I want to use tonight in this little baggie. But there were some other ones, too, that are really cute. Like, here's a little beaver. It's cute. And here's another little fox. I had a whole bunch of little ones. And the little skunk. I like the little skunk. And then there was like, there was a little raccoon and a hedgehog. There was a whole bunch of different little animals in there. So whatever you like for animals. And I think there might have been a little mouse in there. So there was a whole bunch of different ones that I got in those packs. So I have a little box that I can still make some pillows because I've got more animals. Okay, so this is the ones we're going to use tonight. Oh, thank you, Carol. Yeah, so Carol reminded everybody to give me a thumbs up on YouTube and on Facebook. And also, if you don't mind, if you haven't subscribed to my channel on YouTube, I am like 15 people away from 5,000 subscribers. I cannot believe it. You guys are so nice. So if you haven't
subscribe to my channel, please go do that, because it, to get me over 5,000, I'm at like 4987 or something like that. So that'd be awesome. Aren't those cute little buttons? I just love them. Okay, so we are going to get our buttons out of the way here. Go to the back page of the instructions. Now, there's one instruction that I sometimes don't do, and I'll explain. So when I trim my panels, I told you to trim them a half an inch all the way around all four sides. And the reason I do that is sometimes it's hard to remember what side's going where. So sometimes it's easier to do some trimming later. But what I do normally is the pieces that need to be sewn together in the center, I like those to be half inch. I have to need to have my outside edges out here be quarter inch. So I just trimmed mine quarter inch. So the outside edges, like where the binding is going to be. Okay. I hot glue them on, Cindy. You can sew them if you want to, but I'll show you a little trick to help them stay on. So I am going to hot glue them on. So when I tell you to sew half an inch, or to trim a half an inch from the basting line all the way around, I don't usually do that. I do half inch on the sides that are going to be sewn together. And then I do quarter inch on the outside edges. So like this is the center panel. So it's a half inch on both sides, and then a quarter inch on the top and the bottom. Okay, that's how I did that. And then the left-hand side, of course, would be quarter inch on the top, the left edge, and the bottom edge. And then it's half inch on the inside. Okay. And then the right hand, hey, hi, Kathy. The right hand one is going to be, the half inch will be on this side, the left side. And then the quarter inch on the top, the right side, and the bottom. Okay. So, oh, do you cast from YouTube, Cindy, so you on your TV, or do you cast from Facebook? I can't cast from Facebook to some of my TVs because they don't have the right app. So I get frustrated and I get tired of, I don't try it anymore. A couple of my TVs will work, but a couple of them won't. So, all right. So that's the explanation about the trimming. So if you don't want to do half an inch and then trim down to a quarter of an inch later, you can do it this way as long as you remember where you're trimming. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to sew these together in the order they belong here. Make sure I get them sewn. So I'm going to put these right sides together. So I've got the left one. And the center one. Now, the other thing you want to do is make sure you get your little border evened here. So when you're pinning these together, just be careful you get them even and lined up. So I'm just going to put a pin there to hold those together, and let's get another pin here. Let's see here. Yeah, the comments go by so quickly. I have to be careful that I'm paying attention. So, all right. So now, when I sew this together, I also tell you to use a half inch seam. Okay. Now, I don't actually use a half inch seam with a mark on my machine or anything. What I do is I look at the lines here that were the basting stitches, and there's two lines right here. You want to sew in between those two lines, okay? And that's your half inch. I never measure. I just sew. I look at the back of my pillow, the lines there, and I sew between the two lines, okay? And I am using some Pima cotton thread in the needle and the bobbin. Okay. And I've got those two lines. There's two little lines that are very close together, and I'm going to sew right down in between. Okay. I've got my machine set at like 2.5 for the length, so it's pretty tight. And I'm sewing right down between those two lines. I've learned that if I go do exactly a half inch, something shows all the time and I can't, you know, like one of my lines shows or something. So I've always just used the lines on the back to help me sew it together properly. And I'm just sewing down right in between those two lines. All right, we're going to tie off down here and see how we did. Hey, Kathy and Orlin, I can't see your names either. So if you would go and click that little link, then I can see your names. All right, so let's take a look here how we did. Well, that looks pretty good. Okay. All right. So it looks like I'm pretty even. Now I can see my white line just a teeny bit on this side. It's not too bad. So if that happens, if you see a line, and I don't know if you can even see it, it's so small. But if you see that and you don't like it, what I do is I look at the side that I can see the line on, which is the middle side. And then I'm going to, instead of turning it the way I had it before, I'm actually going to turn it to that side. And I'm just going to sew down that again to make sure that I've got it all covered. So if you have to sew it twice, it's okay. I do this all the time. I've done lots of quilts this way. And also these pillows. And you just have to kind of look at your lines. And I'm sewing right down in between those two little lines. It's a little hard on the to see on the camera, I'm sure, because it's white. But you can see it when you're sewing on it. All right. Broken needle on you. I've done that. I've been doing that all weekend, I think. All right. So now I can see that I'm a little bit off at the top. It's not too bad, but I might actually rip it out because I don't like it. So, you know, if things like that happen, then you just get the seam ripper out. And we'll take it out because I'm not happy with how my border is lining up here. It must have scooted on me. So, you know, then you just do it again. I've done this a few times. All right. So the trick is we want these little lines to line up here. Okay. Okay. So I'm just going to tear it back a little bit and then we'll just reline it up. The bottom one looked pretty good, but this one just wanted to scoot for some reason. That's why I always put a pin in there, like right at the seam line, so that it won't scoot, but I must not have quite got it this time. So let's try it again here. Since somebody's going to get this pillow, I want it to look beautiful. I have so much fun making these. I've made a lot of them, of course, since I've digitized all these and had to make all the samples, and I've made so many of these. Maybe, Carol. I don't use a walking foot very often when I'm doing this kind of stuff because I'm just sewing. So no, I don't know. It might help a little bit. There, see? I just didn't have it lined up. Looks good now. Okay, so there's the first side. All right, and then I'm gonna go ahead, but see, then you got to see me rip too. My seam ripper and I are very good friends. Yes. So Janet, if you came in late, the pillow is going to be the giveaway tonight. Okay, so again, I'm gonna line up those borders, and I'm gonna put a pin right there so that it doesn't scoot on me. Okay, see if we can get this one lined up. That looks pretty good. This one was pretty easy to line up. Every now and then I run across one that's hard. Oh, Jackie. Oh, you could. Yes, Jackie. Thank you for recommending these. Jackie, my friend Jackie in Davenport recommended that I make more of these because she liked them and did a bunch. I think you've done all of them, haven't you, Jackie? I think you've made all of them too. All right, so we're going to do the same thing here. I'm sewing down between the two little lines. Make sure everything's lined up here. And it helps if you're very accurate with your trimming. Again, I still kind of use the lines on the back of the pillow to help me sew it. And I don't like measure half an inch because I find that I don't always, half of an inch is a really, really hard measurement on a machine because there's not really a good place to really guide by. So I've always struggled with half inch seams. I never seems like I have an accurate half inch seam. All right, so let's see how we did on this one. Yes, so I'm gonna press my seams open. I'm gonna press my seams open. So I'll go over here to my iron. So let's see how we did here. Ooh, that looks good. This one's lined up and this one's lined up. So I did better this time. All right, so there's our top. The top is all done. I do sew over these pins slowly and only these pins. Mary's asking about my pins. I only use these. These are called magic pins and they're extra fine patchwork. They're very, very, very soft. And I do slowly with certain things, like when I'm piecing and stuff. You don't have to, you can pull them out. But if I pull it out, I know it's going to scoot on me. So yes, I do. These are very, very soft. They won't hurt your machine. If you don't like to sew over them, don't sew over them. But I do very carefully. I'm careful with it. Okay. All right. So we're going to go ahead and I'm going to go press my seams open on the back and then we'll put the backing on. Give me just a second here. Now be aware when you're pressing from the back, it's fine. But remember, you have some glitter vinyl on here, so you don't want to lay your iron right down on that glitter vinyl. Okay. You hear a very hot iron. Yes, I have it's a reliable steam generator iron, and it is really a good iron. So, and I really liked. I mean, I had a first one. I had one at a first one, and then this is a second one because this one's way better than the first one. So where can you get the pins, Helen? You can get them on shieldsewingcenter.com. We have all that stuff, and they're called magic pins, and they're extra fine patchwork. And you can see how soft they are. Watch what I can do with this. They have the flat ones like this, and then they're the original ones I had that I love so much were these, and they're round. But I really, really love these flat ones because you can grab them and pull them out easier. And so, but watch how soft these are. I can just take my fingers and go like this to see how soft it is. They're just so soft. So I like these pins a lot and they're super sharp. So if you like a good pin that's very sharp, these are awesome pins. Even if you don't drive over them, they're really good pins because they're very sharp. Okay. So now we are going to go ahead and I'm going to look at the instruction because this is always one that I get a lot of questions about. So if you had trimmed all of your panels to half inch all the way around, now is the time before we want to go to put it together that you would then trim the outside edges down to a quarter of an inch. And I say that in instruction number 2. Okay. So if you had done yours all half inch, now I've already done mine at quarter of an inch when I cut mine to begin with. So, cause I remembered that I have to have the outside at quarter of an inch. Okay. So now we're going to go ahead and make our envelope back. So since this one is going to have, an envelope back and binding, we're going to do this differently. I'm going to lay this upside down. You know, wrong side's going to be up on my table. I normally do this on the table, but I'll do it on the sewing machine so you can see me do this. You might not be able to see the whole thing. Okay. So then I'm going to take my hemmed backs. I have two backs and they were 12 by 14 and I hemmed quarter of an inch over on one 12 inch side on each one. Okay. And I'm going to put those wrong sides down on the back of my pillow cover here. And then the hemmed edge is going to be in the middle. The two hemmed edges will be in the middle. So I'm just going to lay these down. And this is the way you do it when you're doing binding, because we're going to just put this together, wrong sides together. Okay, and then I'm going to go ahead and pin this on. So I'll start with some corners here. I apologize if you can't see. So I'm lining up all the raw edges over here. Okay, it's a little hard because it's long. So I'm going to line up all my raw edges, put a few pins in here, like this. And then I'm going to come down and I'm going to pin so I know where the hem is. I always like to know where the hem is. I think there's about 3 inches of overlap or so. I like to have about 3 inches or so. There's enough. It's just not going to gap on the back. I'll show you the other pillow in a little bit here. So I like to be able to put a pin where the hem is. Okay. Yes, Maureen, this is how I've done all of my settee pillows. I like the look of the binding around it because it looks like it has piping. And I was thinking about putting piping on the pillow, but piping is kind of hard to do, you know, and I wanted them to be easy. And that's why I decided to do it this way, because it looks sort of like piping. Okay, so I'm going to put a couple pins here on this side. It's a little easier if you could take this like to your cutting table and do it, but this way you can see what I'm doing. Okay, and then we're going to do the same thing on the other side. So I'll turn it this way. We're going to line up the raw edges and put the hem in the middle, right side up. So the wrong sides are together, and we're going to go ahead and pin. Oops, can't get my pins here. They're running away from me. We're going to put the pin in the corner here. Do the ends first. Yeah, so I was going to do them a different way. I was originally going to do piping, and then when I started looking at them, I thought, the piping sometimes is hard. I think piping is sometimes hard to do. And it's hard to get it to the where you start and stop to come together. And so I thought this is so much easier. Okay, so there's where our hem is on this side. Oh, somebody's sewing with me tonight. Margaret, are you making yours tonight, Margaret? And then I'm going to take, here's the other hem right here. I'm going to put this pin, I'm going to move it over to the other hem because I like to know where the hems are so I know that I've got it all the way around. Yeah, Clara, I know the Coats and Clark bobbins are very expensive. They've gone up so much. You can use with your PR. They're not my favorite bobbins, but you could use Magna Glides. They're called Magna Glides, and they're from Philtech. They're not my favorite bobbin, but they work. And they're cheaper than the Coats bobbins have gotten so horribly expensive because they're very hard to find, if you can find them. That's the problem. Okay, so now what we're going to do, I've got it all pinned. I'm going to turn it right side up so I can see what I'm doing here. And this is instruction number, I have to find it here. number six. Okay. So that I'm going to, I hemmed one short end of each one of my back panels. So I have the hem. The hem is right here. See, that's where the hem is, Linda. So I have a hem on the end of each one, and they're overlapped about 4 inches or so. So you want to hem one. I didn't do that in the class because I already pre-hemmed. So you need to hem one short end of each of your back panels so that that's how you make the envelope back. Okay. So there's a hem here and there's a hem right in here, if I can get to it, right in here. Okay. So there's the other hem. Okay. You got it? All right. So now I'm going to turn this right side up so I can see where I'm going. And I'm going to sew all the way around this at about an eighth of an inch just to hold this together. And what I like to do is I like to use the notches on my J foot. I'm going to put the edge of the fabric right along the outside notch that's on the right-hand side of the foot here. And I'm just going to leave my needle in the center position. And I'm going to sew around. And that's about an eighth of an inch top stitch. And I probably will pull the pins on this one because I'm not worried about it scooting. And I'm just going to go all about an eighth of an inch all the way around. But I like to do this from the top so that I know I'm not going to have anything showing on my binding when I go to put my binding on. Okay, so we're going to get to the corner here. Yep, hopefully turn this around. So, Claire, if you have another more questions about the bobbins or need help finding them, why don't you just email me and I will tell you where to find them, okay? For your PR. Because I totally understand. I've been using the other bobbins. I don't like them as well, but they work. And they're way cheaper. Yeah, during the pandemic, we started having a lot of trouble with getting pre-wound bobbins, and it was for the multiple needle machines. I do a lot of my embroidery on my multiple needle as well. And the bobbins got very, very expensive. So I'm still doing my eighth of an inch top stitch. And I also put a post up on the group on Facebook. I've had a lot of people asking me, they can't remember what the website is. And so I put that on the Facebook group so that you can click if you want to get the design. Because a lot of people were asking me, they couldn't remember what the name of the website was. So it's my sew-along-with-jan.square.site. All right, so we're still doing our eighth of an inch. It's just going to hold these together. So when we go to put the binding on, we're not struggling to keep everything together here. All right, getting around there. And be careful the pins, by the way, because they're very, very sharp. It's like a lancet. So if you need to draw some blood, you'll be able to do it with these pins because, man, are they sharp. And you don't think about pins and how sharp they are. Some pins are just so dull. And I had some pins at the store that I still had in my box at the store, and I used one of them. I'm like, oh my gosh, I couldn't even get it through the fabric. It was so dull. So I now have these pins at the store too. Oh yeah, the turning the corners. We'll do that again. My grandma's trick. Somebody said they like the turning trick. We'll do that here. Actually, we don't have to do it with this one because we're going to put binding on it since we're not turning it. I'll show you on something else though. We'll do it on the pillow that we're going to make in the couching class. All right, so I'm all the way around. I'm just going to tie off. Yep, my grandma's trick for the turning the corners. A lot of you have seen that. So, all right, so we got it all the way around. I think I got all the pins out. Okay, so there is our cover ready to go for binding. Okay, now, so depending on what kind of binding you like, I like to put my binding on with my sewing machine. Okay, completely. So if you like binding to hand stitch it down, Yeah, that's funny, Lisa. I'm going to switch over to a gray thread now. I got this gray that matches my binding. I like to have matchy thread for my binding. And that matching bobbin. And I like it to be pretty matchy. So what I do is if I don't have something that matches really close, I use monofilament. And this one, I do have this light gray that matches pretty well. So we're just going to use this light gray thread. And when I sew my binding on, so if you want your binding to be sewn on and then turned around and hand stitched, you will sew your binding on the front of your pillow. If you're going to do it like I do it, I'm going to sew it on with the sewing machine. So I'm going to actually install my binding from the back. So mine is going to be sewn on the back and brought to the front. Okay. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and just show you how to do the binding. I'm trying to find the bottom. Here we go. All right. So I have my binding all prepared here. It's all ironed and everything. And we're just going to start down here on the bottom. I'm going to leave a little tail, maybe 7-8 inches or so, just to give me a little something to work with. And I'm going to go over here on my machine, and I'm going to use, I'm going to go to the Q tab, and I'm going to go to Q02, which is my quarter inch piecing stitch. I like to use my J foot when I'm piecing, because then I don't have to remove the foot to do zigzag, because I will need to zigzag here in a few minutes. So with this Q02 piecing stitch, it moves my needle over to the 5.5 station, and then I can just run my fabric right along the edge of my foot, and that is a quarter of an inch. So then you don't have to move your, you don't have to take your foot off. And if you like a piecing foot, just go ahead and use your piecing foot. All right, so we're going to go ahead and get this lined up, and I'm just going to start, I'm going to tie off. And I'm going to get this lined up, and we're going to sew down to about a quarter of an inch from the end of the pillow top. Now, I have to say that I don't really measure that anymore. I can kind of tell that I'm about a quarter of an inch. So we're just going to kind of go with that, and I'm going to tie off a quarter of an inch from the end. If you want to measure, go ahead and measure. I kind of know where the quarter inch is now. Right, so there we've got our first part of our seam. I'm going to take my binding, and I am sewing with the raw edges together, as you can see the folded edges in here. And I'm going to fold this up at a 45 degree angle, get it nice and straight, and then I'm going to pull straight down and line up the raw edges like that. Then we're going to start on the corner here. So in other words, Lisa, you prick your fingers a lot with your Oh no! Kathy lost her hot chocolate because she left it sitting on the counter. Oh no, that's too bad, Kathy. Maybe you'll have to make yourself some more. I had ice cream before we started. Had pizza and ice cream. Doesn't that sound like a good supper? I had to go to Costco tonight, so I didn't have time for much supper before class. We have a retreat tomorrow at the store, and so I always like to get treats for the girls. Okay, so I'm about a quarter of an inch from my end. Okay, and then I'm going to cut it off. You can, Carol. I'll show you how I do it, and it's actually, that's not the way I learned. I do it. I'll show you how I do it. It's very easy. So yes, I know some people that do that, and there's a special ruler that you can get for the binding. It's a binding ruler that you can actually make that angle first. But I've always done it this way. So I don't know. I just learned this way. I've got I'll try to link this in the video description too. It's called Bind Aid. It was just a piece of paper that a friend of mine gave me years ago about it, so I could learn how to bind. Okay, so we're going around another corner here. I got it all folded and flat again. So this is the way it showed me how to bind, and this is always the way I've done it. And I've never had any problems, so I assume I'm doing okay with it. So, but I learned how to do the machine binding from GE Designs Gudrun Urla. She's very good quilter and is a wonderful teacher, and I really enjoyed her classes, and I developed this binding from watching some of her videos of how she did it. I do it a little differently than she does, but I really like doing binding this way, because I don't have to, I make so many samples, it's very hard for me to do hand sewing. Okay, so we're doing this on the back, trying to get everything lined up here. Still doing my quarter inch seam using my piecing stitch. We're going to go down here to about a quarter of an inch from the bottom. Okay. Trying to see if I've missed anything. Oh, somebody's phone went dead. Victoria, your phone went dead. This is a good way to do it. And I've done a lot of binding. I mean, it seems like that's all I've done the last few years is bind things. And so, I mean, it moves along pretty quickly, and I can do this pretty fast now. So, okay. So I'm going to do my corner again. I'm going to go up at a 45 degree angle, get all my lines lined up here. And then I'm going to line up my raw edges again, straight down. And I barely have enough binding. My binding's a little short because I was using up some scrap fabric, and I had enough, believe it or not, to bind two quilts, or two of these pillow tops, I should say, out of this binding. And there was just like a little scrap left is all there was left of it. So I couldn't remember where I got this. This I got somewhere besides, I think the rest of it all came from Walmart, but this one was different. So I did get some fabric at Walmart. I made a third pillow cover for my friend, and I did get some other binding, and that one was pretty too. It was a little darker than this, but I liked it. So I did that one in the darker color, gray. All right, so we're doing our quarter inch seam down the other side here. Yeah, I think I have one of those binding tools. They have this little binding tool that has like a bevel on the end to help you do that little flip at the end, but I've never used it really. I've learned to do it this way, and it works just fine for me. Okay, so now we're going to go around this other corner. So I stopped about a quarter of an inch from the end, get my corner all lined up here. Okay, and then flip this over, get it all lined up, and then make sure my raw edges are lined up. So I've done quite a few binding videos, but I thought, you know, it doesn't hurt to show people how I actually finish this whole thing. And I have to do it anyway, right? So I might as well just turn the camera on and let you watch me. So then we're all on the same page here. All right, so we're going to go up here. Now, I'm not going to go all the way up to the other side. I want to leave a little gap here so that it's just a little easier for me to move this around. So we're going to kind of go up maybe to around here, and then we'll stop. That looks pretty good. So I'm just going to tie off. Yes, all of my settee pillows have the binding on them, Cindy. You don't have to put the binding on. You can just turn them right sides together and then turn them out if you want to. You don't have to put the binding on. I just think the binding looks, it really adds a lot to it. Makes it look like piping along the edge of the pillow. So, okay. So now we've got our little gap here, and now we need to do that little flip at the end. So let me get my hem gauge and my marking pen. And we're going to take the end that, this is the end that we finished with, and I'm going to just lay it along the seam here, and I'm going to turn it over, okay? Then I'm going to lay the end that we started with over the top, like this. Now, what we want to do then is I think I'm going to cut just a little bit of the first end off because I'm going to kind of come out a little too close here. So we'll just cut a little bit off here first to start. Because I'm going to come out and I don't want to have to rip it out. So we'll just trim this off just a little bit. Okay. All right. So now here's where I ended. Okay. And here's where I started. So I've got that over the top. And I'm going to take my hem gauge and I have it set to 2¼ inches because my binding was 2¼ inches wide. If your binding is 2½ inches wide, you would set it to 2½. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to measure my 2¼ inches in, and I'm going to put a pin in the back piece of binding. So I'm just going to put this in here. Like that. And there's my 2¼ inches. I think I might be just a little bit long. So we're just going to bring it in just a little and remeasure just to make sure. Like that. Now I'm a little shy, so I think I was about right. So we'll move it back a little bit. You want to be pretty accurate with that measurement. All right, let's see. That looks better. Okay. So then what I'm going to do. No, you can do multiple, Lynette, you can do multiple designs at a time, but you cannot buy physical and downloadable product at the same time. So in other words, you can't buy a bow maker and designs at the same time because the bow maker has to be shipped. It's just the way my little website works. So I apologize about that. But no, you can do multiple designs at the same time. All right, so I'm going to fold that where the pin is. I'm going to take my pin out, and then we're going to trim this off right there. So I have a little bitty bit of binding left. Okay, so there's our two pieces. So now, this is where everybody gets kind of confused, and I did for a long time until I really looked at that little picture. So I'm going to take the part that we started with, and I'm going to lay it down at a 45-degree angle like this, okay? I'm going to take the part where we ended, and I'm going to open it up like this and lay it flat on the top like this. Then I'm going to take this end. I've got it at a 45-degree angle, and I'm going to continue on in the same direction. So I moved it down this way, and I'm just going to keep on going, okay? So I see how I have the 45-degree angle. I'm going to kind of open it up so I can hang on to the open binding. And then I'm just going to keep going in that same direction. And then I'm going to bring it up and we're going to pin the corners together. Get some pins here. So we need 3 pins. Oh, Jackie, you took your Christmas pillow down. So now you're ready to put up your winter pillow and have you put your winter pillow up? And then you can put your Valentine pillow up. So we're going to do a spring one, and I think that'll be in March. Probably the last class in March. We'll do a spring one. So I have to digitize it yet. I know what it's going to be called, but I haven't digitized it yet. Okay, so now I have my corner. Okay, my corner is pinned. So I got to take my little marking pen and I want to mark where the corner is so I can see both sides of the corner. And you can mark all the way across here if you want. I usually just do the corners so I can see. I can aim pretty well. So I'm just going to mark my corners with my marking pen. There we go. All right. So I'm going to get this out of the way. And then what I need to do is I'm going to fold this up. And we need to lay this all flat here so that the pins, so that we can sew this together flat. Oops, I just lost a pin, didn't I? Get that out of the way. Okay. Now I'm going to move my needle to the center position. Can I show you one more time? I can. Somebody wanted me to show one more time the little flip. Okay. So when you flip it, it is a little confusing. I have to say, I really, really looked at the pictures a lot on that Bind-Aid. I really liked it because it helped me. So here's the end that we started. I'm going to put it at a 45-degree angle. Okay. This end where we ended, I'm going to lay flat like this. Okay, with the wrong side down. Then I'm going to take this end. I'm going to kind of open it up like this, like I'm going to put the right sides together, and I'm just going to continue on in the same direction. So see, I started this way, I turned it this way, and we're just going to go right on up this way. So you're kind of twisting it. It looks weird. Okay, it looks weird because it's going to kind of twist. You're going to keep going the same direction, okay? And it does look weird. So once you pin it together, and if you're not sure if you did it right, here's the little trick. I'm just going to pin it together, maybe. My hands are so dry, my goodness. It's amazing how dry it is this time of year. My hands get so dry. All right, so do this, and then let me get, whoops, I think I dropped the other pin. Oh yeah, the laser light works too, Robin. Yep, I just eyeball it. It's not that far. I don't have, oh, I just stabbed myself. I hopefully I don't bleed on my pillow here. Okay, so then I'm gonna do that. Now, if you need to be assured that you've got it right, just kind of go like this and leave the pins in there. And can you see that it's gonna lay flat, even though the pins are in there? Okay, because the twist is a little confusing, I agree. Okay, so now we're gonna lay it flat here. I still got my little marks on there. And we're going to sew from corner to corner. So I'm just going to sew from one mark to the other. Take a couple stitches here, and then I can get this laid flat. And sew across. Okay. I won't. I didn't bleed. I didn't poke myself hard enough, but I felt it. Robin said not to bleed on the pillow. Oh my gosh. I love these pins, but oh my gosh, they're sharp. And I'm always poking myself with them. Okay. So then this is where you pray that, you know, everything lays flat, and it does. So we're going to take this piece out of here. You can tell that it's going to be flat, but we're going to take, oh, except it's not, because look, I got a little pucker in there. So we'll have to fix that. I always get a little, sometimes I get a little pucker when I go to, oh, maybe it'll be okay though. I think it was just on the edge. There we go. Yep, it'll be fine. So that is going to lay flat. So now I can trim that out of there. It's very hard to get them. If you don't leave enough space between, it's very hard to get it to lay flat enough to sew across. So make sure you leave a little space there. It really helps if there's enough so that it'll lay flat. Okay, and then I'm going to open this up, the seam up. And finger press it down. Can't quite get to this one. There we go. Okay, and then we'll lay it flat like that. So now we're ready to sew the rest of this on. Now I always like to pin these, this one, just to make sure everything's okay. Blood gives it life. That's what I always say. If you bleed on your projects, it has life then, doesn't it? All right, so we'll get this lined up here. Second, I think I got a little off on this one. There we go. I think I bleed on almost everything I make because I'm always stabbing myself with something. The one thing that really hurts is when you stab yourself with the seam ripper, that really hurts. Okay. So then I've got, whoops, I think I put one more pin in here. So this is going to be our opening, and we're going to go back to our Q02 to get our quarter inch piecing stitch again. I always do the diagonal with the needle in the center, if I didn't tell you that. So I always put the needle in the center to do that. It's easier. All right, so we're going to get this lined up here and tie off. I'm just going to sew a little bit over where we ended there. Do our quarter inch. Just being very careful with the pins. Don't go over them 100 miles an hour. Okay, there we go. Is no washing dishes? I don't wash dishes, Carol. I have a dishwasher. Thank God. When I was at my dad's house, I had to wash dishes. I've never washed so many dishes in my whole life as I did that 13 months because my dad did not have a dishwasher. And boy, did I miss my dishwasher. I was very happy to get home to my dishwasher. Okay, so there is our binding. So this is on the back. So what we're going to do is I am going to go. So the next step, we need to press this out on the back. So normally, like when we do binding, they always say not to press it, you know, but with this, we need to have a nice crisp press on the back when you're doing it with the sewing machine. Otherwise you're going to miss. So we need to go press this. So I'm going to go press this from the back and I'm going to get a nice crisp press right along a whole binding. Okay. Oh yeah, that's Jackie. That's fine. Jackie said that she sewed her buttons on first before she put it together. And that is fine. My buttons have shanks, so you would almost have to before you put it together because it would be hard to get your hands in there to do it. So if you're sewing your buttons on, I always glue. So okay, so give me a second. I'm gonna go press this out with the iron with good steam. Okay, so it's important to get that very crisp seam there, okay, before we move on. So that's what, boy, I got all kinds of little strings here. We're going to have to do a little trimming. Tons of little strings. Okay. All right, so now we're ready to put the binding down on the front. Boy, I got strings everywhere. My heavens. Okay, so we're going to turn this right side up. We've got our nice crisp line there. So now what we're going to do is we're going to make our beautiful corners on the front. Yeah, that's fine. If you're going to sew your buttons on, I would recommend you do that before you put the pillow together because it would be easier. I don't like to sew buttons on, so I'm going to glue mine on. But I'll show you a trick to do that too. All right, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to make my beautiful corners. And I'm going to take some clover clips and I'm going to clip on like a little bit from each corner of my top here. I'm going to pull it to the front and we're just going to line up the binding right on our sewing line that we just made. And I'm just going to put a clip on each corner on each side. Okay. And then, let's turn it over. Do this one. So I'm just bringing the binding up to the line, my stitching line, and I'm just going to clip it just to hold it in place. And I don't clip anything else. I just do there'll be 8 clips. And in fact, I only do 8 clips when I do big quilts too. I do 1 clip on each side of the corner. That's the only clips I put on. The rest of it, I just hold. All right, I'm going to bring this around. Bring this around. Okay. Whoops. Got some more strings. We better get rid of the strings. All right. So now we got to make our beautiful corners. So to make the corner, I'm going to take my binding and you want to put it just up to your stitching line. So make sure it's lined up. I'm going to take my thumb up into the corner I'm going to lay it right along my stitching line and get my pin ready here. I'm going to push this up to a 45 degree angle. Okay. And then I'm going to bring it down directly down to the other stitching line right on the other side. And I'm going to put my pin right in that corner and out the top to hold that in place. Okay. So there's my beautiful corner from the front. So we're going to do that four times. We're going to do it on each corner. Get my pin ready. I'm going to lay this down on the line. Push it up into the corner. Make my 45 degree angle. And then pull it down and match it up to the line on the other side. And this one's a little off, so I have to kind of rearrange here just a little bit. Sometimes I have to stab the corner there to get it started. There we go. Oops. There's always one corner or two, just so you know. That always seems to be harder to do. I don't know why. Must be Murphy's Law. Okay, there we go. Let me get the pin in there and up the top like that. So I think I'm still a little off on this one. This is the corner, you know, hopefully the other corners will go faster. You always get one that's just kind of contrary. I don't know why. Let's see if I can get this one. There we go. That's better. Boy, this one just doesn't want to go, does it? I had one on my original one that didn't want to go too. There we go. Maybe I got it now. There. Okay. That's better. But there's always one. All right, so let's go do another one here. Then I'm going to push this up into the corner. Push your thumb up into the loop. You got to grab my bob, my pin again. Okay, go over 45 degree angle and pull down. Now this one's going to be a little easier. Okay, and push your pin in there, and we're going to leave those pins in because we don't want that little beautiful corner to scoot on us. So, okay, and then I'm going to go up to the corner, grab my pin. Up to the corner and down. This one's being kind of it's not being very friendly. There we go. All right, there we go. Put the pin in there and push up. So then that holds those beautiful corners in place. That is not a good beautiful corner though. We're going to try it again. These take me a minute to do. I do. I can go drive around faster and do the zigzagging than I can get the pins in the corners. I can go pretty fast now going around the edges. All right. Did I get it this time? I think I did. That looks better. Okay. There we go. So then we got our corners. My binding strips are 2 1/4 inches. Somebody asked how big the binding strips were. I can't see who it was, but I do 2 1/4. I like 2 1/4. I like my binding to be snug, okay? All right, so now we're ready to start zigzagging. So give me a second, I gotta grab my glasses, I forgot them. I usually need my glasses for my zigzagging. And we are going to use a zigzag stitch. I use zigzag when I do this instead of a straight stitch because I never get it right with a straight stitch. I like a zigzag. So I'm going to go into my regular tab number 1, and I have a special setting on my 1-10, and I like to use the width of 2 and the length of 1.4 to do my binding. Okay, so I always set it up on my 1-10, and then it's always set up that way, and I save it in there. Okay. Yeah, I like the 2 1/4 just because it's nice and snug. Okay, so now I like to start at the bottom. So we're gonna start at the bottom here. I'm gonna bring this around, and I'm gonna bring my binding just around to my sewing line, okay? Just to my sewing line. And then I'm going to put my foot down here, put my binding out of the way. And I'm going to put this J foot. I like to use my J foot. There's a little notch right in the center of the foot. And I want to put that right on the edge of my binding. So with the 2 millimeter zigzag, it is going to be, you're going to do one stitch. The left-hand stitch will be off the binding. The right-hand stitch will be on the binding, okay? So I'm just going to start. I'm going to tie it off. The right-hand stitch is on the binding. The left-hand stitch is off the binding. And bring your binding right up to the line where you sewed it on. And I can sew pretty fast now. I've gotten pretty, as long as I wear my glasses, I can sew along on this pretty fast now. And I'm just lining up my binding. The left hand stitch is off the binding. The right hand is on the binding. Okay. Oops, I got some more strings. We'll see if we can get the strings tucked in there. Now, I may not be able to answer questions too well while I'm doing this because I'm concentrating. So I can't look up as much when I'm doing this. Okay. Then when we get towards the corner here, say the numbers again on the zigzag. Oh, okay. The numbers on the zigzag, it's 2 millimeters wide and 1.4 millimeters long. And I use it on my, I just save that in my machine on my 1-10 zigzag stitch. Okay, so we're going to the corner. Now, when we get to this corner, I'm going to zigzag into the corner slowly. Because, you know, that pin's going to stay in there, okay? Then I'm going to turn the corner. And if you notice, my foot went up. I've got my pivot feature on. And I'm going to see how I did. It looks like I might need to take one more stitch. Because you want it to line up. And my goal is to put my little mark in the middle of my foot, right on the edge of my foot. Now, see, I overshot it just a little bit. So I'm going to put my foot down. I'm going to raise my needle, and I'm just going to slide over so that that is in the right position so that my little notch is right on the edge of my binding. I'm going to take that next clip out, get everything lined up, and zigzag out of the corner. Okay, line everything up. If you got any strings, you want to get rid of the strings. This one was a kind of a ravelly fabric for some reason. So we'll get it all lined up. The left hand stitch is off the binding. The right hand one is on. And it took me a while to get used to doing this. This was a little bit of a learning curve. And after I figured out a measurement, you know, like a width of the zigzag that worked for me. And when you use really matchy thread, you really don't see it. And the zigzag, I don't miss. I don't miss. And especially if you're doing stuff like and I even do this on quilts now. I mean, like every now and then I would say I'd probably do hand quilting, you know, hand binding. But I figure I use my quilts and I think the machine binding's stronger. You know, it's going to hold better through washing and everything. I use my quilts. When I make quilts, I use them. And they're on my bed and, you know, in my living room and stuff like that. So I don't want my binding to come off. All right, let's see how I did pretty well that time. So I got lined up. My notch is right on my binding area here. So let's take this one out. Okay, and then I can come out of that corner. Oops, second here. I'm going to take that pin out. It's tied down, but sometimes I'll have to take the pin out just to get around the corner because sometimes it wants to catch on the edge of the foot. So it should be fine. It was already sewed down. So I like to leave the pin in there because then it keeps that corner nice and even. I think this one's okay though. Yeah, it's still okay. Boy, have I got strings though. Sometimes I got to do some trimming when I'm going around here. All right, so I'm lining that up right with my line. Keep going around. Got a couple little hairs here I got to trim out. All right. We're getting about ready to do the fun part. Put the little animals on. All right. Getting around here. Left stitch is off the binding, right stitch is on. But I tried this with straight stitching. I've tried all different kinds of binding this way, and I've never done a good job of binding until I started doing it with a zigzag. And it does show a little bit, but if you don't, if you have very matchy thread, it doesn't. And if you use monofilament, it doesn't show. I mean, you can just barely see it. Like I did a great big quilt that's right next to me, and I can just barely see it because I use monofilament on this one. Yeah, this is the one I use monofilament on. Just kind of got to hold your binding down so it doesn't shift on you. And I'm going to take this clip off because when you get to the corner, I kind of have to take my fingernail and kind of pull back a little bit so that it straightens my binding out. Like that. So I just kind of spread my fingers apart and hold it down right on my line. So I'm using my sewing line to help me. And then I'm just a little off here. So I got to lay it out a little bit more. There we go. Get it all laid flat. And then we're going to zigzag carefully into the corner. Okay, then we're going to turn the corner. It can melt. Somebody asked about the monofilament melting. It depends on what you use, the kind you use. I use that Mettler Transfill, and I've never had any trouble because I have pressed it. So I do use the Mettler Transfill is what I use. I think it depends on the kind you use and what kind of, some of them are made out of, I think some are made out of nylon and some of them are made out of, mine's not. What is the monofilament? I'll have to look on the spool. But that Mettler Transfill is awesome. And it actually, you can put it in the bobbin and you can actually do really well with it. I struggle with monofilaments. I tried quite a few before I found this Transfill. We've always used Mettler thread at the store. And so I just bought some of it because I thought, well, can't hurt because, I mean, we use Mettler everything else. And man, is that good monofilament. You just have to be careful with it. All right. So we're getting close here. So let me put my finger on the corner here. Pull back. I'm going to go into the corner. And I think I'm going to not win the bobbin chicken. I thought maybe I'd make it, but I'm not sure. We'll see. I may be winding a bobbin here for you in a minute, too. Looks like I may not quite make it. I knew I was getting close. When you zigzag, of course, it takes a little more thread. No, I don't want to cover. Somebody asked if I want to cover my line. No, because if you cover your line, you're going to see stitches on the back of your quilt, not on the binding. So the point of bringing it right up to it is that you're sewing actually on the binding on the back. Because you have that crisp seam, you're going to have you're actually sewing on the binding. So when I turn this over, you'll see, and I'll show you, because then you're not going to see a line or a zigzag on your actual item. But I have a feeling I'm going to have to stop and wind a bobbin here in a minute. A Because the goal is you're actually sewing on the binding on the back as well. I do have a little thread here I need to get rid of. Let's see here. Must have had a end. There we go. Okay. Uh-oh, I've got my friend here. Just a second. I'm trying to make sure she doesn't put her nose on the glue gun. She's very upset because her ironing pad is covered with stuff and she can't sit down on it. Okay, let's see. I don't know. I never win bobbin chicken. Do you guys win bobbin chicken? I hardly ever do, so we'll see if I can make it. Getting really close, but I don't know. Let's see. Well, it's still sewing, so that means I'm still sewing, right? All right, let's see if we can make it. Oh, I might have made it. Might have made it. All right. Now, when you get to the end, don't take too many stitches over, because you want to, your zigzags will show then. So try to only do maybe a stitch or so over, because you don't want it to show up too much. Hi. Hi, Gigi. Okay. She decided she needed to sit on my lap. So we're going to cut that off. And we made it around. And look, I didn't run out of bobbin thread. There's still a little bit left in there. All right. So I'm going to trim my little tail off here. Trim my little tails off the back. Now I'm going to show you. Hopefully you can see this. When you look at the back, can you see how the stitches are on the binding? Like this. You see how the stitches are on the binding? Now see, I've got a little bit off on this corner right here. There's just a teeny little spot right here that I didn't. But my goal is to stay right on the binding and not have any stitches here. And every now and then I'll go into the corner and I'll still miss just a little bit, but that's not too bad. Okay, so we'll see how the stitches are on the right on the binding on the back. And that's the back. And that's why you want to do a really, really good press, because then it's nice and flat in the back. Okay, so let me see here. Let's get the pins out before I stab myself with them. And there is our top. We did it. So there's the binding on the top. Okay. Isn't that pretty? I like that the zigzag stitch works for me. And you know, some people are doing the same kind of method, but then they do a straight stitch. So if that works for you, do the straight stitch instead. Okay. So now we're ready to finish our pillow. So then somebody can win this pillow. Okay. So let me see here. I'm going to lay my other pillow in front of me here. Hopefully I don't have a mad cat, because I'm going to squish her here in a minute. She's sitting here helping me. Okay. It is, mine are getting better. The trick is to practice as you get better. And the only time I have a little trouble is when I'm doing the corners. I still have a little trouble in the corners sometimes. You know, I had one little corner here that wasn't quite perfect. I must not have pressed quite well enough in that corner. So I have one little corner, but you won't see it, because when you put the pillow in it, it's going to kind of cover all that up, so you won't see it. The rest of the corners look pretty good though. Yeah, the rest of the corners look pretty good. It's just that one. And I'm still, you know, I've been doing this for a couple years now, and you know, I'm getting better at it too. Okay, so now we're going to put these buttons on. Let me get my pin out of here. And this is the buttons I wanted to put on this one. And these are all my little woodland animals here. So let's see, I have a little squirrel and I have a little bunny. I'm going to put the little bunny over here. Let's pull this back just a little bit. We're going to put the little bunny over here. And we're going to put, oh, I've got a little fox. So we're going to put the little fox over here with the squirrel. And then I think I'm going to put, oh, not sure. Which do you think? I had two different owls. These are both cute. I'm not sure which owl. I'm going to put an owl up in this tree, but I'm not sure which one. So maybe you can choose. You like the lighter color or the darker colored owl? I don't have a skunk. Does somebody want me to put the skunk on? I like the skunk. Should I put the skunk on instead of the fox? And then here's a little deer. Then I'm going to put these little cardinals up here. Let's see, I put the cardinals up in the tree. So put those up there like this. Put this one down here. Somebody want a skunk? Yeah, the dark does show better. This one's a little bit light colored. So I thought he was cute though, because he was kind of looking to the side. Yep, you like the dark one? Okay. All right, so we'll do the dark one. All right, so now this is my trick with the buttons. I don't have a skunk on this one. Do you want? No skunk. Okay, we won't put the skunk on. We'll put the little fox on instead. All right, so this is my trick with the buttons. These have shanks on the back. And so what I do is I take a pair of like paper scissors, you know, like scissors that I don't care so much about. And I'm going to cut those shanks off. So I'm just going to take the scissors and I'm going to cut that shank off so it's flat. And I'm going to do that on all of these buttons. Then they lay flat and you can put plenty of glue on them. Okay. So I'm going to do that to all of these. All of these were shank buttons. Get those out of here. Let's see. Got the squirrel done. Got to get the little fox done. And this is, they're soft enough plastic that they come off pretty easily. So I'm just going to cut these all off. A little cardinal. I have to go see if I can find some more cardinals at Hobby Lobby. I got them in Cedar Rapids instead of in Iowa City, though. I'll have to see if they have them here. I haven't looked. Okay. So then here's the little bunnies. You know, I don't wash my stuff. Somebody asked if they think they'll fall off. And, you know, they might, but you might, you know, you probably could just glue them back on too. I have a lot of things that are glued on and I really don't have much trouble with them coming off. If you want to sew it on. I just don't like to sew buttons on. I hate it. So, but I usually use hot glue. And then these, since I've got them flat enough now, they do glue on pretty well. Okay. Yeah, in the paper section. Yeah, I'm not sure if ours did. I got them in Cedar Rapids. I know I was up in Cedar Rapids that day when I went to get them. So, okay, so I'm going to grab my glue gun here. And we're going to put our let's start with the little deer here. So we'll put this one on. But see, now that they're flat, you can put quite a bit of glue on it. See, you can put more glue on these because they're bigger buttons. I'm just going to put that one kind of between the little trees there. Like that. Okay, and let's get our cardinal. Pull this over a little bit so you can see. And even the cardinals are pretty good sized. I'm going to put him on the tree limb down here. Okay, then here's my little squirrel. So let's put our little squirrel. Oh yeah, no, my fingers are pretty tough now because I use a glue gun a lot. I do like this glue gun though. I finally found a glue gun that I like. Okay, so there's our little squirrel. Get our fox on here. So yeah, if you like to sew on buttons, just sew the buttons on. That's fine. I just don't like to sew buttons on. Okay, whoops, I got all kinds of little strings though. Yeah, so I'll go check out the Hobby Lobby here and see if they have any more cardinals. So I have a few more. I have other animals, but I just don't have any more cardinals. Okay, so let's get the bunny. I just love these little lop-eared bunnies. Aren't they cute? Those were in the, one of the, I think this was in, the bunnies were in the Backyard Babies, I think. Or the Backyard Buddies, I think it was called. We'll put the bunny on. Okay, and then let's get, are there special pliers for taking the shanks off? I didn't know that. I've always just used my paper scissors. But I always just use some scissors I don't care so much about. Okay, we'll put this one up here on the tree. There's some buttons that don't glue very well. And the little tiny buttons that are so small, they don't glue very well just because they're so small. There's just not, you can't put enough glue on them. Like these are pretty big. So these actually stay on pretty well. All right, so let's put some glue on our little owl guy here. And put him up in the tree. like that. I'm just kind of setting them like they're setting on a limb. Oh, what's the name? The name of my glue gun? My glue gun. I love this glue gun. I finally found some glue guns I like. This is a mini Gorilla glue gun. It's Gorilla glue. I got them at Walmart, but yeah, I've seen them other places. And it's a hot, low temperature, high temperature, low temperature one. I really like it. And it's got a little tip on it. And it doesn't drip. I mean, this is the most wonderful glue gun. And I've got like three of them. And it took me a long time to find a glue gun that worked for me. Because I'd never have liked a glue gun. All right. So what do you think? There's our little animals are all on the pillow top. So the person that wins this tonight does not get the pillow form. They're just going to get the cover. Okay. So, and I got the pillow form at Hobby Lobby. And it is 12 by 22, and they should have them. Okay. So there's our little pillow. These are so much fun to make. I hope you enjoyed this project. We're going to make a few more of these this year. I'm going to do one, like I said, we're going to do a spring one. So we'll do a spring one in probably in March. I think maybe the second class in March, we'll do the spring one. And then we'll do one in the summer, and we'll do one in the fall. I don't know if we're going to do I might possibly do another Christmas one, but I haven't decided yet. I was thinking about doing a Christmas one too, but I've already done one Christmas one. I have an idea for a Christmas one though, so I might. All right, so there is our pillow cover. And this is gonna be the gift for tonight. So somebody will get this pillow cover with the little buttons on it. So I hope you enjoyed this project as much as I have. So let me bring the camera up so we can say goodbye and have the drawing. Just a second here. All right. So don't forget, if you haven't
subscribed to my YouTube channel, I'm very, very close to 5,000. So if you haven't subscribed, please go subscribe and get me over 5,000. I'm just about there. And I appreciate you guys so much. And then also give me a thumbs up on YouTube and on Facebook. So I appreciate it. Okay. All right. So the winner will get this. Now, if you're away from here, if you're not local, if you're away from here, please, and this has to be someone from the United States. I know we've got a couple people from Canada. I can't ship outside of the States. So if you win, can you let me know that so I could pick another name? It's only for people in the United States because I have to ship it if you're from away from here, obviously. If you're local, then I will send it to the store or have it at the store for you, okay? But then you will need to email me at janshieldssewing@gmail.com to give me your address, your mailing address, or you can also message me through Facebook, okay, to give me your mailing address if you win the prize. So the prize will be this. Okay, so just a second here. Let me go get I have my little tool here that it's been helping me the whole class. All right, let's see here what happens. Are you ready? We're going to draw. Here we go. Just a second here. I'm drawing. It's going. Had a bunch of entries tonight. The winner is Diane. Is it LaBurge? 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 Diane? Because Diane and I were talking about some stuff earlier. So Diane LaBurge has won the pillow. In fact, I have to ask, she wanted to see if she had double paid for something. I have your name on here. So Diane, can you send me your address? I'm just going to write this down so I don't forget. One pillow, so I don't forget. And I needed to go check something else out for you too. So Diane LaBurge is the winner. So Diane, please message me your mailing address, or you can email me also. So Diane won the pillow tonight. Isn't that exciting? It's so fun to do these kind of things. And I enjoy the giveaways. I enjoy doing that too. So I enjoy giving away some things. And I have lots and lots of really cute things to give away. So I have to go through some more of my stuff to find some more giveaways. But I wanted to give away the pillow tonight. So, okay. So next week, we will not have class. But remember, I will have a pre-recorded video for this, for the shaker card, the Valentine shaker card, okay? And it's done with the scan and cut. This is a free design from Canvas Workspace. So you can get that for free. And then that will be next week. And then the first week in February, we'll be making the cute little, a little birdie told me, Kimberbell quilt. And that's a free one. So go to kimberbell.com, go to their download area where they had the free downloads are, and go ahead and download that free design, and we'll make that cute little pillow. So thanks everybody for joining me tonight. I hope you had a good time. I had a great time. So, and I will see you all in about 2 weeks. So it's the first week, the first Wednesday of February. What is that day? I can't remember. Let's see. It is February 7th. That's the day that you'll see us, and we'll do the little pillow. And then on the 30th, on next week, you know, sometime early next week, I'll post the scan and cut class for you for the little card and the envelope. I taught you how to do the envelope. So thanks everybody. Have a great evening.